Hi, I'm Rishina, and today I'm going to be talking about the key performance indicators or KPI in your embryology lab. It is very important to standardize operations in your embryology lab. So say you've standardized your SOPs, you've standardized certain other things in your laboratory as in how certain procedures are to be done, but you still see a dip in your pregnancy rates. What do you do now? That's where KPI comes into picture. So say if you're a team of 3 to 4 embryologists, what you will realize after setting these benchmarks is that there are some embryologists who are performing under the benchmark and some who are hitting all the benchmarks. So all the embryologists in your laboratory may not necessarily be working in the same way, and that is extremely important for them to have their benchmarks. So there are certain benchmarks that we measure in the embryology lab. I will go over them quickly. For more detail, you can obviously refer to the article on our website. But some of the ones which are very important are fertilization rate, degeneration rate, blastulation rate, cleavage rate, pregnancy rate, implantation rate, and lastly, and a very important one, the live birth rate. Now, across the globe, like when you look at papers, there will be different benchmarks set by different clinics. Be sure to set your own benchmark and keep increasing the benchmark as you start hitting those benchmarks. So say if as a lab you have your benchmark of fertilization at 70% and you notice that consistently all your embryologists are getting a 78% fertilization for the last 6 months, raise that benchmark, make it to 75. That will always keep you motivated to do better. The other reason for these benchmarks or setting these KPIs is that if an embryologist is underperforming, say if embryologist in your laboratory is getting a 65% fertilization, that's when you will know that you need to observe his or her procedure, ICSI procedure, and maybe tweak a little things. So imagine if you didn't have any benchmarks or KPIs, it would just be a wild guess that okay, maybe it's the SOP, it's the cold chain, it's really difficult to pinpoint. So having these benchmarks is very important. The other question that we get asked very often is that how often should you analyze these? So as per us, there should be something, a monthly analysis that you should be doing for your laboratory and your embryologist. Apart from that, you should have a quarterly analysis. So get your benchmarks, analyze it as a team, and analyze your benchmarks or your KPIs monthly, quarterly, and if your clinic is growing, even yearly. That will give you a very nice, detailed analysis about how you're performing. Hope that helped. For more information, as always, please log on to our website and get in touch with us for more information. Thank you.